We are going to make sea monster in the shape of a jellyfish or octopus. Inflate balloon leaving about 2-3 inch flat tail. Squeeze the balloon to make it soft. Pump the air to the end of the flat tail. We are going to use 4 balloons to make, I would say, medium size sculpture. It is a Halloween season. Orange and black preferable colors for this occasion. Fold the balloon in half. Mark the spot. Twist the bubble. We have made 2 tentacles. We can use 1 balloon per tentacle to make a larger size sculptures. Then it would take 8 balloons to make it. Well, if you work with 160s, then you can use 1 balloon to make 4 tentacles. We have to twist all balloons in the same way and lock all balloons in the center in 1 lock twist. In this example, I twist and lock all balloons one by one. You can speed it up. Just hold all 4 balloons in 1 hand at the middle to twist and lock them all in 1 move. Try to make all tentacles of the same size. Slight difference up to 1 inch in size of tentacles will not be really noticeable when we're done with this sculpture. Alright, here we have connected all 8 tentacles. The sculpture looks like some kind of a star at this point. Our next step varies. It depends on what we want to make. Suppose we want to make a jellyfish. Put the sculpture aside for now. Get a flat balloon of any color and tie both ends of the flat balloon in 1 knot. Put your hand through the loop of the flat balloon. Hold the sculpture at the center in the hand with the flat balloon on it. Use your other hand to roll the flat balloon down the sculpture. I place the flat balloon about 1/3 or 1/4 of the length of the sculpture down from the center. You can use appropriate size a rubber band instead of the flat balloon. The only purpose of the band is to keep all bubbles together. Here's the side view. The loose ends of the balloons represent tentacles. Let's shape them. Basically, I threefold each tentacle. It is very simple, as you can see it. The top part of the sculpture represents the head or the body of the jellyfish. I don't know the proper name for it. So what do you call it? A belly head? I guess something like that. Okay, here I have to shape couple more tentacles. And then we are going to decorate the top part of the sculpture. We can use the simplest makeup. Yes, a permanent black marker. It will do the magic. Just draw the eyes. Here I am shaping the last tentacle. That's it. Congratulations. We have made the jellyfish. Instead of using a permanent black marker for decoration, we can use a spare balloon to make the eyes. Here I'm going to use a black balloon. Actually, we need just a couple inch piece of balloon, not entire balloon. Twist a chain of 2 soft 1 inch bubbles. Now we have to lock all ends of 2 bubbles in 1 lock twist. You can use scissors to cut off the rest of the balloon, or do it with your fingers, it's up to you. We have made the eyeballs. Okay, here we choose any bubble in the upper part of the sculpture. Twist a bubble, I made it about 5 inch. Right here we attach the eyeballs. Once again, we fix all bubbles in proper positions. Congratulations, we have made the sea monster. That's a front view, here's a bottom view. The side view and the top view. Now we are going to use the same sculpture to make a bit different sea monster. Remove the rubber band. Instead of rubber band, we twist bubbles and lock them together. We can twist bubbles one by one or in bunch. It is possible to twist all 8 bubbles in one move. In this example, I twist and lock 3 bubbles in one move. Now I'm going to twist and lock all other bubbles one by one. Sculpture made in this way has more distinguished head than the previous sculpture. I'm not really sure if this sculpture looks like an octopus. Well, at least it has the same number of tentacles as all octopus supposed to have. 8 tentacles. Here we have 2 more bubbles to twist before we'll be done with this sea monster. Most certainly twisting all bubbles in one move saves a lot of time. It's not easy to hold 8 balloons in one hand, but no one says that you have to hold balloons only in your hands. We can use our entire body for this purpose. Anytime I have to twist big number of balloons at once, I hold them under my armpit or between legs. Okay, congratulations, we have made the sea monster. Let's fix all bubbles in proper positions. Previously we have made the eyes and have already shaped the tentacles as well. So there is not much left to do, but enjoy the sculpture. Here's the front view, the side view, the back view, and the bottom view. Here is a different color sea monster. I made it blue with 8 or 7 eyes. I use a permanent black marker to draw the eyes in this example. In my experience, little kids love to play with this kind of toys, so I really suggest you give it a try. Have fun and happy twisting!